It is often necessary to test concrete structures after the concrete has hardened to determine whether the structure is suitable for its design use. Ideally, such testing should be done without damaging the concrete surface. Different types of tests available for the testing of concrete, but today I am going to discuss rebound hammer test. To know it in detail, stay tuned with this video up to the end, and it is really appreciable if you like this video and subscribe my channel. So dear friends, let's learn something. Rebound hammer test is non-destructive testing method of concrete, which provide a convenient and rapid indication of the compressive strength of the concrete. It is also called as a Smith hammer test that consists of a spring controlled mass that slides on a plunger within a tubular housing. As per the Indian Code 13311 Part 2 1992, an objective of rebound hammer test is to determine the compressive strength of the concrete by relating the rebound index and the compressive strength to assess the uniformity of the concrete, to assess the quality of the concrete based on the standard specifications, and to relate one concrete element with other in terms of the quality. Generally, rebound hammer test method can be used to differentiate the acceptable and questionable parts of the structure, or to compare two different structures based on its strength criteria. Now, if we talk about the operation of rebound hammer testing, then during testing, when the plunger of a rebound hammer is pressed against the surface of the concrete, a spring controlled mass with a constant energy is made to hit concrete surface to rebound back. The extent of rebound, which is a measure of the surface hardness, is measured on a graduated scale. This measured value is designated as rebound number or rebound index. A concrete with low strength and low stiffness will absorb more energy to yield in a lower rebound value. The compressive strength can be read directly from the graph provided on the body of the hammer. The impact energy required for the rebound hammer is different for different type of the applications. Like for normal weight concrete, it is about 2.25. For lightweight concrete, for small and impact resisting concrete part, it is 0.75, and for mass concrete testing, it is 30. There are certain points required to remember while performing the rebound hammer test. Number one is the concrete surface should be smooth, clean and dry. Number two is end loose particles should be removed off from the concrete surface with a grinding wheel or stone before hammering testing. Number three is rebound hammer test should not be conducted on rough surfaces as a result of incomplete compaction, loose of grout, sparred or tolled concrete surface. The point of impact of rebound hammer on the concrete surface should be at least 20 mm away from the edge of the discontinuity. Number 5 is 6 readings of the rebound hammer is taken at each point testing, and an average of the value of that readings is taken as rebound index for the corresponding point of observation on concrete surface. The most suitable method of obtaining the correlation between compressive strength of concrete and rebound number is to test the concrete cubes using compression testing machine as well as using hammer test simultaneously. First, the rebound number of the concrete cube is taken, and then after, the compressive strength is tested on compression testing machine. After obtaining the correlation between compressive strength and rebound hammer number, the strength of structure can be assessed. In general, the number increases as the strength increases and is also affected by a number of parameters. Parameters like type of cement, type of aggregate, surface condition and moisture content of the concrete, curing and age of concrete, carbonation of concrete, etc. Moreover, the rebound index is indicative of compressive strength of concrete up to a limited depth from the surface. The internal cracks, flows or heterogeneity across the cross section will not be indicated by a rebound hammer. If we observe the quality of concrete for respective average rebound number. If number is more than 40, it is with a very good hard layer. Between 30 to 40, it is a good layer. 20 to 30, it is a fair concrete. And less than 20, it is known as poor concrete. If it is zero, then concrete is delaminated. As such, the estimation of strength of concrete by rebound hammer cannot be held to be very accurate. And probable accuracy of prediction of concrete strength in a structure is plus or minus 25%. If the relationship between rebound index and compressive strength can be found by test on core samples obtained from the structure or standard specimens made with the same concrete material and mixed proportion, then and then the accuracy of the results and confidence thereon gets greatly increased. The advantages of rebound hammer test are, number one is that apparatus is easy to use. Number two is determines uniformity property of the surface. Number three is the equipment is inexpensive. Number four is used for the rehabilitation of old monuments. Now if we talk about disadvantages of rebound hammer test, then number one is the results obtained is based on a local point only. Number two is the test results are not directly related to the strength and the deformation property of the surface. Number three is the probe and spring arrangement will be required regular cleaning and maintenance. Number four is flows cannot be detected with accuracy. So dear friends, this is all about rebound hammer test of concrete. Let's meet with another video with new topic and fresh knowledge. Till then, goodbye and take care.